Hello everyone, another little video here about the hammerhead. Some were asking about how my method of building is and whatnot, and how I, you know, can make it accurate and whatnot, so I'll show you how I do it. Okay, so here it is, the head. I add some details to it, beveled the edges and cut it here and whatnot, added these parts to it. Basically, the wrench shape is a block. This is a very tiny block of it right here. Right there, that there is a great big old block of it sitting there with all that stuff on top of it. So, but you can cut it in a bandsaw over there, or you can mill it, you know. That's mainly what I do. What I do is I would draw this profile on a block, you know, draw this out. And then what I do is I'll take it and I'll cut it in the bandsaw like that. And then I'll draw it from the front view, and I'll cut it in the bandsaw this way as well. So you have basically a square version of this with these angles. But before I cut this angle, I'd put it in the mill over there to cut out these parts, you know, so they'd be totally vertical. You try to do this when it's like this, you're in your trouble. So yeah, those are cut out and cut through, as you can see. So then I hog it out too in the mill, and you can see how it's straight out. And then what I'm going to do is, now that I got these pieces in here, I'll put a bead of Bondo in here to smooth it all out, because you know this is going to be molded as one piece. Now this is the head, as you can see, and you can see I added a line here. What I had, and, this, and the reason for this, oh, it's upside down, there you go. The reason for this is because I went by this drawing. And I went by this drawing, you know, that's right here, right? But when I noticed the circle here, the circle didn't look right according to these pictures here. Boom, boom, you know. I can just tell that there's something not right. So I used a circle template and figured out the right size, which is that one there. I'm sorry. Yeah, this one. That one there, and to put it in the proper place has to be about in there somewhere. On the fan, this is a fan-made picture here, this whole picture here. And the ones I've been using did a great job, but there is a few discrepancies that have to be addressed, and this is one of them. So anyways, so that's how I found out that the head was not thick enough, so I had to add 1/4 inch to bring it out. Then when you look at these pictures, for instance, you can kind of see it, that it is a bit thicker on this one than on this one, you know. And that's okay, you know, it's fine, it happens. So that's what I did, is I added here. And then I cleaned out here, and then what I do is I put a smear of Bondo in here, because when I mold it up, you know, the details were kind of showing through on the back. So you want to smooth it out the best you can in here, and then hog it out, which I did on my mill over there. So, matter of fact, this little model here, which is very, I call it the pregnant version, you can even see here on the turret that it's up closer, more into the head than this one, which is not hardly in the head at all, not even half of it's, you know, going within the head itself. So, yeah, just things to watch out for, you know, when you're doing something where you have to make sure it's really accurate. And so, these are actually from, I think it was a documentary, it was a turnaround. That's why their quality isn't that great. Of course, these are screenshots, I guess. And so you kind of want to pick and choose your battles, and which is the best, which is not. Like, for instance, the detail in here, it's not accurate to the model. There's no way anybody's going to know or even see it. This here, this is the best picture I got. And as you can see, it's just stuff. You can't really see anything. Just a stupid reflection. There's no way it's descriptive at all. You know, it's just busy. So that's what I do. I do that with my Star Destroyer, like the detail in the trenches and all that, other than distinctive details, which would keep pretty accurate. So I think, yeah, always holding this thing upside down. You know, this thing has an eyebrow that goes across here, which I'll use this thin plastic that I seem to have lost. Nope, that's not it. Oh, there it is. Is that what you're pointing at?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I didn't know. I thought you were pointing at this for some reason.
Oh.
You know, because when you point like that, you know, it doesn't. So it gets this eyebrow in here like that, which as you can see on, this is the best one to show it. The reflection there. You can see it has that, sort of this eyebrow, they painted a different color. And then they do is they put notches in it, like there's a notch and it drops down, then it comes back up around the window and then drop. And so what I'll do is I'll glue this on here, then I'll put this in the middle and I'll notch it in to bring it up and, you know, to have those notches. And that'll be the eyebrow. And then I'll make a circular piece here, part of a circle. And then on the back piece we'll have just another part of a circle. And then this whole disc right here will fit on that entire piece as one piece, you know, as a separate casted part. And then a little box for the interior. Nobody really knows what the interior looks like. I've looked at pictures from Rogue One. Just looking at pictures from Rogue One, and you know, like I said, everything's in the script. If somebody notices how accurate the, you know, if they have a good accurate picture of the set, if there was even a set for the interior, who knows if it was a blue screen. Yeah, I'd be happy to get it. Be glad to get it, and I can make it fairly accurate. But looking at screen grabs, it was the best I can do. And that's like 5 seconds when the guy says, you know, prepare for a collision or something like that, the guy with the funny helmet. So, anyways. Yeah, and I added the fins to this thing. A little Bondo in here, and then it gets lots of plates all over it and stuff. So, yeah, we're starting to take a little shape other than just a bunch of dumb tubes, PVC and plexiglass tubes. And detail, you know, here. Still gonna put details along this edge here, which is made of this stuff here, which is from the Bandai 144 scale Falcon. So, you know, so nice, cool looking detail to stick on there in the script. And of course, yeah, this piece here, which I think I showed in video of how I had to rebuild it. And yeah, that's the table so far, the desk full of papers and reference, making sure it's right so everybody will want it and not hate it. So I guess that's it. Talk to y'all later. Bye.